The next thing is your experience, your key experience. Now, you know, I have about 28 organizations that I've worked with, whether as an employee, whether as a consultant, whether as a counsel, whether as an advisor. I won't go and write all of them in one line. I write only three most important or four most important at max in that, and two to three lines about it. You know, I worked with Law School's Admissions Council that produces the LSAT India exam. And I was the director for brand and outreach, assistant director for brand and outreach. My statement after that for my role in LSAT goes, leveraged my skills to introduce the new model of engagement with partner institutions and establish an outreach program with over 900 schools in India, resulting in 10,000 students participating in the mass outreach. With this, also helped the leadership produce a mega event for foreign universities in India and was regularly involved in advising the leadership on strategy, outreach, and go to market. Right? So, you know, when you put all of this together, you see how I what I did? I mentioned about the core thing that I did, the secondary thing that I did, and the overall result that I brought into the organization with numbers. Anyone who's going to hire you would like to see numbers. Would like to see what you can bring as a result. Talent is great. Talent is wonderful. But talent will not get you a job alone. It might get your foot in the door, but you will have to prove yourself every day with results. And results can only come with discipline and consistency. I'll give you an example. Again, from a personal life thing. Last 2 weeks, I was in Delhi. So some of you might have attended a program that we did with Advocate Anuj Agarwal earlier last week. And, you know, in that program, I was there in Delhi and taking it from a public space. Now, today I'm traveling again with a client and I'm here at a university's campus and speaking with the pro chancellor and the dean and other people. But that doesn't mean that you give up on your commitments. All I did was make a polite request, an affirmative polite request. And said, hey, could you just, you know, allow the guest house to be used by me for a while to take a call? Now, you see, this simply shows the rigor and the discipline that I'm willing to put in what I want to do or what I've been asked to do, either or. Now, if I'm able to do this over and over and over a period of time, it'll automatically bring consistency, right? So now, whether do I bring results or not, this discipline and consistency is going to reflect in whatever I want to write into my profile or resume or CV. And people know me, right? So that is how you validate what you've done. That is how you validate what you've written in your profile.